Deep in the abyss of space, there exist mysterious and enigmatic objects that continue to baffle astronomers and astrophysicists alike. Black holes. In this documentary, we will uncover the secrets of these cosmic wonders and explore their most fascinating aspects. Delve into the mysteries of what happens when you fall into a black hole. Ponder the fate of the Earth if it were to encounter one, and discover why these gravitational titans play a crucial role in our understanding of the universe. We'll also explore the tantalizing idea that a supermassive black hole lies at the heart of every galaxy, and how we know that to be true.
We see all this activity in the center of the galaxy, stars orbiting a big dark area. How do we know it's not just like the center of a hurricane? And the reason why we know that is because what we learned from Kepler and later Newton is the orbit that you have is the speed of your orbit is completely determined by the mass that's sitting inside your orbit. So what you say is, here are these things, I can see how fast they're moving, run back to Kepler's equation and say there must be a mass like bigger than the size of the orbit. And then you say, but wait a minute, we don't know anything that's that massive that's smaller than the orbit except for the black hole. This is dark, and it has huge mass, and it's small. That's three smoking guns right there, implicating a supermassive black hole.
Throughout the vast expanse of the cosmos, black holes have long stirred the curiosity of scientists and stargazers alike. These remarkable entities, the remnants of massive stars, possess a gravitational force so powerful that not even light can escape their clutches. The formation of a black hole is an awe-inspiring event, marking the violent end of a massive star's life cycle. As the star exhausts its nuclear fuel, it succumbs to the crushing force of its own gravity, ultimately collapsing in on itself. If the core's mass is large enough, this catastrophic collapse will give rise to a black hole capable of warping space-time and devouring everything in its path. Black holes come in various sizes and types. Stellar mass black holes form from the remnants of massive stars, while intermediate mass black holes remain somewhat of a mystery. The true giants of the cosmos, however, are the supermassive black holes, which lurk in the centers of galaxies, including our very own Milky Way. As we probe deeper into the enigmatic world of black holes, let's pause for a moment to explore the intriguing realm of white dwarfs and neutron stars. These dense, compact remnants are the end products of a star's life cycle, formed when a star sheds its outer layer and ceases nuclear fusion. Although not as mysterious as their more massive counterparts, white dwarfs and neutron stars still hold their own cosmic allure, with fascinating properties that defy our everyday understanding of the universe.
So there are various states of matter. Why is a rock a rock? Because something is preventing it from collapsing. So what is it? Well, it's the forces between molecules and atoms. So now, it turns out under high enough pressure, you can collapse that and close down the gaps that are between those atoms and molecules. Now they get closer and you get something called electron degeneracy. They're so tightly packed that you're trying to cram electrons into the space of other electrons and they don't allow that from quantum physics. So they keep their own identity within the structure. And we have matter out there that resembles it. It's called white dwarfs. White dwarfs are electron degenerate and they're extremely dense. Wait a minute, you can go further, okay? There's still the gap between the nucleus of an atom and the electrons themselves. Right. Let's collapse that gap. And that is the biggest gap of them all. You know what that gap is? Take a football stadium and then put a mustard seed. Put that in the middle of the stadium. That's the nucleus, and the outer sides of the stadium is the orbits of the electrons. Atoms are mostly empty space. First dude to determine this, his name was J.J. Thompson, and he was the first person to realize that matter is mostly empty space. The next stage is collapsing everything down, and you're cramming the electrons into the protons, because they're no longer can they separate themselves, but they're not going to occupy the same space anymore. They're crammed together. If you combine a proton and an electron, what happens to the charge? It becomes what? You put them together, you create a neutron. So you don't have the electron degeneracy, and you have a pack of neutrons. That is the densest matter that exists out there that is not a black hole. So these are called neutron stars.
Black holes are not merely voracious cosmic vacuum cleaners. They also play a pivotal role in the formation and evolution of galaxies. Their tremendous gravitational pull can regulate galaxy growth, shape the distribution of stars, and even trigger the birth of new stellar systems. In fact, scientists postulate that the presence of supermassive black holes might be indispensable to the very existence of galaxies like our own. Moreover, black holes can emit powerful jets of plasma at near light speeds, extending millions of light years across the universe. These jets, fueled by the black hole's accretion disk, can have far-reaching consequences on the surrounding cosmic environment. These jets can influence the large-scale structure of the universe, impact star formation, and even affect the distribution of galaxies. As we continue to unlock the enigmas of these gravitational titans, the burning question lingers. What would happen if you fell into a black hole?
Your feet first falling towards the black hole. The stretch feels good, but then it becomes unrelenting. Because your height is now a bigger and bigger fraction of the distance you are to the center of the black hole. So now, you start sliding in, and there will be a point where the tidal force exceeds the molecular forces that keep your body attached as one piece. So you will snap into two parts. And since all the forces are operating uniformly across your body, I think you'll initially snap at your lower spine. So those are the two bits. Now, those two parts of you continue to feel the tidal force. So they stretch. And so your bottom half snaps into two pieces. Your upper torso snaps into two pieces. And as best as I can judge, that would be at the base of your neck. Now, your brain is still working. You can, in principle, see this. This happens pretty fast. So now you're in four pieces. And they continue to feel the tidal force. And then you go from 2 to 4 to 8 to 16 to 32 to 64. And this continues until you are a stream of atoms, like a train of atoms pouring down to the singularity. And that's not the worst of it. The fabric of space and time funnels and gets narrower and narrower because it ends up at a singularity. So whatever horizontal volume you occupied, you become extruded through the fabric of space like toothpaste through a tube. This form of death has a name, and it's called spaghettification.
The awe-inspiring and terrifying power of black holes has long captivated our imagination. In the quest to understand these enigmatic celestial objects, the detection of gravitational waves has played a significant role. These ripples in space-time, produced by the collision of massive cosmic entities like black holes and neutron stars, have allowed us to hear the universe in a way never before possible. The groundbreaking discovery of gravitational waves has not only revolutionized our understanding of black holes, but has also opened new doors in the pursuit of unraveling the mysteries of the universe. But what transpires when one of these cosmic giants targets an unsuspecting star? As the black hole's unyielding gravitational pull begins to tear the star apart, a mesmerizing cosmic spectacle unfurls before our very eyes. The star's material is drawn inexorably forward, forming an accretion disk that emits intense radiation, resulting in a brilliant glow visible across the vast expanse of the cosmos. This enthralling phenomenon, known as a tidal disruption event, highlights the formidable strength of black holes as they feast on the celestial banquet laid before them. As we observe the violent and mesmerizing process of a black hole devouring a star, we gain a deeper appreciation for the tremendous forces at play. In the face of such formidable forces, it is only natural for us to contemplate a chilling question. What would happen if our beloved Earth were to encounter a black hole?
If Earth happened upon a black hole that was traveling through space, an encounter between Earth and a black hole, Earth loses. Now, because we know about this tidal force that will stretch things, where the side of the Earth nearest the black hole will experience a much higher force of gravity than the side that's farthest, that means the side closest to the black hole will pull towards it faster than the side of the Earth, and so you'll end up stretching Earth. The problem with the word stretch is, you know, Earth is not Gumby. Earth is not made of rubber. Earth is made of sort of solid substance. If you're going to stretch, put under stress the solid sphere that is Earth will basically begin to crumble into smaller and smaller bits of rock. So Earth will distort, become more and more oblong until the strength of the materials can't hold that shape anymore. And then it'll start sort of crumbling apart. And we call that spaghettification, is when you start becoming this long strand. But again, spaghetti is one continuous string. This will be a stream of particles.